Good morning. This morning I came 8,000 miles away from the USA to NCF just to wish each and every one of you a Happy New Year. But where are you? Where's everyone at? Happy New Year!
Actually, I'm still here in the USA. But it's a joy to be with you this morning, and I'm so grateful for this opportunity to share God's word with you. I have a message God has given entitled Confidence in the Chaos. Here in the USA, my mobile service provider is AT&T. It's like your Airtel or your Jio there in India. There's a comical commercial that AT&T put out this year that I want to share with you. Let's check it out.
Have you ever worked with Dr. Francis?
Oh yeah, he's okay.
Just okay?
Guess who just got reinstated? Well, not officially. Nervous?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Don't worry about it, we'll figure it out. I'll see you in there.
Just okay is not okay, especially when it comes to your network.
Can you imagine going into surgery with a surgeon that is not confident? I wouldn't. I'm sure you wouldn't either. We value confidence. Did you know that there's a similar commercial in God's Word? I want to share it with you from Jeremiah chapter 17, verses 5 through 8. I'm reading from the New Living Translation, Jeremiah chapter 17. Verses 5 through 8. This is what the Lord says. Cursed are those who put their trust in mere humans, who rely on human strength and turn their hearts away from the Lord. They are like stunted shrubs in the desert with no hope for the future. They will live in barren wilderness in an uninhabitable, salty land, but blessed are those who trust in the Lord and have made the Lord their hope and confidence. They are like trees planted along a riverbank with roots that reach deep into the water. Such trees are not bothered by the heat or worried about long months of drought. Their leaves stay green and they never stop producing fruit. Amen. Can you picture this passage being turned into a commercial of just okay is not okay? Here God is saying, if we put our confidence in man, we're going to be disappointed. We're going to lose confidence, not gain confidence. But if we put our trust in God, we can be confident even in the midst of chaos. The truth is, just okay is not okay. 2020 actually taught us that. Talk about a year of chaos. 2020 came in, and by March, we were all being impacted with unprecedented change, with uncontrollable circumstances, and with uncertainty about the future. That is absolutely a description of chaos. You and I know this chaos. Even today in the USA, senior adults are known to be sleeping in their cars during cold nights in sleeping bags in order to have a hope to get the vaccine. Wow, what a picture of chaos. And this is not going to change anytime soon. So you and I better find confidence in the midst of chaos. Is it even possible? Well, first of all, let's just think about what happens to our confidence. When you and I are in church, it's easy to be confident. When there's plenty of money in the bank, yes, then we are confident. When everyone in our family is enjoying good health, we are confident. But what happens when God seems silent? What happens when all hell breaks loose like we've witnessed in 2020? What happens when there's bad news? When we test positive? When someone is really sick with the virus, when we see loved ones being lost by the virus or by other means? What happens when we're falsely accused? When Christians say mean things about us? When we feel betrayed? What happens when we're hungry and we have no money? Where is our confidence when our Lazarus dies and Jesus hasn't shown up yet? What happens when our bodies are racked in pain? What happens when we face a global pandemic with unprecedented change, with uncontrollable circumstances, with uncertainty about the future? How do you and I have confidence in chaos? Well, let's look at Jeremiah 17. Here, we can see three things that confidence is not. Number one, confidence is not temporary. We're given the analogy of plant life and how having the nourishment and the deep roots that can be near the water and go deep into the water is a form of survival. But when we have thin roots without proper nourishment and water, it's temporary. Well, confidence is not temporary. Number two, confidence is not conditional. It's not conditioned upon our circumstances, upon our emotions. Confidence is not conditional. And three, confidence can't be stolen. I want you to just think of your confidence. For me, I'm confident that I am an American. I hold an American passport. I was born in the United States of America. You cannot steal that away from me. I'm confident that I'm Caucasian. I'm confident that I'm a man. There are many things that you are confident of that cannot be stolen from you. And confidence in the Lord cannot be stolen. Often we give it away, but we need to learn to be confident in chaos and not give our confidence away, not surrender to our confidence. So there's three things that confident is. We see it here in Jeremiah 17. Confidence comes from a living relationship with God. The plant life analogy shows the example of living, dynamic, real, practical relationship with God. And we learn that about confidence, that it comes from a living relationship with God, not just knowing about God, but living daily, walking with God. We also see that confidence is wisdom in action. This passage in Jeremiah 17 is actually titled Wisdom from the Lord. But you see that confidence is not stagnant. Confidence is wisdom in action. And we are warned, if you get your wisdom from man, you're going to find how unreliable that actually is, and your confidence will plummet. But if you get your wisdom from God, your confidence will soar because God is reliable. God does not change, even though our circumstances and our emotions can change. The third thing we see is that confidence is contagious. You know the benefits of being around people that are not confident and how it drains your confidence. You also know the blessing of being around people that are confident and how that boosts your confidence. And so it's important as we look at confidence and chaos that we hang around with the people that are going to build our confidence and not drain our confidence. And I'm not talking about not being active in ministry, but when we realize that our confidence is in the Lord, we can continue to go out and make Christ known and give and sacrifice and bless others in Jesus' name, because our confidence is not being depleted. Our confidence is maintained by the Lord, not by man. I want to share with you this passage out of 2 Chronicles chapter 32, verse 8. Hezekiah talks about contagious confidence. He says, "With him is only the arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. And the people gained confidence from what Hezekiah, the king of Judah, said. When we come to church, when we're listening to God's word, we gain confidence from the leaders of God, from the pastors, the evangelists, the teachers that God puts in front of us. And so let's look at these four words that we see in Jeremiah 17. These words of faith, trust, hope, and confidence. Because these words can get blurry and we can misunderstand these words, but they're all four used here in Jeremiah 17. First of all, let's look at the word faith. Faith is confidence or trust in God. This really helps me because often we are told to put our faith in God, but we're not necessarily challenged or encouraged to let God build our confidence. And we can talk about faith and not really realize the value that faith is really confidence, wisdom in action. It is confidence in the Lord. And so you might feel weak in your faith, but you can be confident in the Lord. So remember, faith is confidence or trust in God. The second word is trust. There's that word. And trust is reliance on the integrity, the character, the strength, the ability, the surety of God. This is confidence. Sometimes we are told that we just need to trust in the Lord, and that is true. But you need to realize that trust is confidence in the character of God, in these things that are unchangeable, the character, the integrity, the strength, the ability, the surety of God. Third, let's consider the word hope. Have you ever been told to put your hope in the Lord? We need to put our hope in the Lord, but you need to understand the value of hope whenever it comes to confidence, because hope is the feeling of what is wanted can be had. It is the feeling that events will turn out for the best. And where do you get your hope? It should derive from your confidence that we are standing on the word of God, on the promises of God, in the character of God, in the identity that we have been given as followers of God, as children of God. All of this should boost our hope. And so fourth, we see confidence, and that is the full trust, the belief in the powers, the trustworthiness, the reliability of God. And so there you have this commercial built out in Jeremiah 17 that just okay is not okay. And if we've learned any takeaway from 2020, this year of chaos that we've all been dealt without our permission, it is that just okay is not okay. We need a confidence that stands the test of chaos around us. And we need this for today because 2021 does not necessarily erase all of the chaos immediately that we were exposed to in 2020. I'm not confident if you are confident, but I am confident of two things. You want to be confident, and God wants you to be confident. So how do we become confident? We'll go back to what we just looked at. Confidence comes from a living relationship with God. So three things about living relationship. It is necessary that you and I hear the voice of God. Are we going to be paying attention to man's voice that is not upholding the word of God? Are we going to hear for ourselves the voice of God? Number two, reading the word of God. One of the greatest ways to hear the voice of God is to read the word of God yourself. When you read the word, you are actually producing confidence for yourself. You need that to have confidence in chaos. Number three, experiencing the character of God. when you read the word, when our circumstances change, we remember the character of God that does not change. Let chaos come. The character of God stands. It does not change. And we need to experience His love, His peace, His kindness, His compassion in the midst of our suffering, in the midst of sorrow, in the midst of chaos. Let me ask you, so what do you value? Do you value hearing the voice of God? Do you value God's voice over people's opinion? Do you value revelation or information? Revelation is what comes directly from God into your spirit, into your life. Third, do you value character or circumstances? What influences you more, the character of God or the circumstances you see and you hear about in the news and you see going on in the culture around us? We should allow the character of God to triumph over our circumstances. I want to close with several words of scripture as you develop a confidence in chaos. We read in Psalm 27, verse 3, though a mighty army surrounds me, my heart will not be afraid. Even if I am attacked, I will remain confident. That's confidence in chaos. Listen to Isaiah 30, verse 15. This is what the Sovereign Lord, the Holy One of Israel, says. Only in returning to me and resting in me will you be saved. In quietness and confidence is your strength. This is how to be confident in chaos. It says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 6, so we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. So I will have no fear. What can mere people do to me? This is what confidence looks like. Do you have confidence in chaos? One final passage before I pray. 1 John chapter 4, verse 17. It says, as we live in God, our love grows more perfect. So we will not be afraid on the day of judgment. But we can face Him with confidence because we live like Jesus here in this world. This is confidence in chaos. Hold your hands out before the Lord as I pray over you this morning. Heavenly Father, I thank you for my friends. I miss them. I'm sad that we can't be present in the same room, but I am so grateful for your presence that transcends thousands of miles as we are apart. And I'm grateful that you are present here in the USA and you are present there in India. And I'm grateful for how you have proven yourself faithful in 2020 to be an ever-present help in time of need. Father, we've needed you and you have been kind, you have been plentiful, and we rejoice in that. Father, I pray for an impartation of confidence over my brothers and sisters today. Father, that in their weakness, they will know that you are strong. Father, thank you that it is not by power nor by might, but it's by your Spirit that we know the confidence, this gift of confidence that you've given to us, even in the midst of chaos. And I pray that blessing over every brother and every sister. Father, as we lift up our hands before you, we know that you are where our confidence, our wisdom, our help comes from. And I pray that these hands would lack no good gift from your hands. Would you burst forth to meet every need, where there's a need for healing, a need for salvation, a need for restoration, a need for financial provision, whatever the need may be, may we be confident that you are kind, that you are plentiful. We put our trust and our hope in you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, God bless you. I look forward to seeing you all very soon. Happy New Year.